My name is Haely Jardas. I'm going to be a sophomore this fall at American University.
Haely, why do you think so many reality shows are choosing DC as their destination of choice?
I think that DC is the next big city. It's not New York anymore, it's DC. We have so many young people, so many new faces, and so much going on in this city that people want to learn about it.
I got an email one day that said, hey, this is happening. There's no entry fee or anything like that. You know, the last Miss DC, the last Miss DC, she was the current at the time, was from AU, Jen Corey. There have been a lot of former Miss DCs from AU, and I figured, oh, why not? We'll see what happens. This is my first pageant that I've ever done, and it was really interesting. There were a lot of things that were myths that I thought were myths that actually happened, like, you actually glue your bathing suit to your butt with glue to keep it in place. I thought that was something that people made up, but it's true. There's a lot of gluing, a lot of taping, a lot of padding. That goes a lot of padding right here that they put in. And when you're trying on the dresses, the women just kind of like stuff it down there. I can't say for other pageants, because this is the only one that I've done, but I know that the way that this pageant for the Miss DC and the Miss America pageants are, you know, organized, there's a lot of it that is based on, you know, how fit do you look, how nice do you look, how well poised are you? Are you well-rounded? Are you doing a lot for your platform? Is she an intelligent person? Does she have a great personality? Is she the kind of person that we want to represent, you know, DC, and the kind of person that we want to represent America? So it's much more than what you look like. The swimsuit section is a swimsuit and fitness lifestyle. So it's not necessarily if you're skinny. There were some girls that were too skinny that they told them they needed to gain some weight. But it's more about how healthy you look and if your body is toned for your body type and if you choose a swimsuit that fits your body the best. I didn't meet one girl who was catty or rude. Everyone was really nice and they were all willing to help each other. And, you know, if I had a question for another girl who had been there the year before, she was able to explain, you know, oh, this is what happens, or like, hey, can I borrow your hairbrush, or something like that. No one was snippy or had that, like, I'm better than all of you, which I have heard some horror stories about girls who are just, you know, snippy and horrible, but apparently that's rare, so I didn't run into anyone who was mean. They were all really nice. I think it's a big misconception for the fact that they get judged so much they get judged by people so much by the onstage question, which, you know, you walk on and they ask you the question right on the spot, and you've got all these people in front of you, and you've got all these cameras flashing in your face, and the lights are on you, and the microphone's in your face, so a lot of times people trip up, and then people think that they're dumb.
I personally believe that US Americans are unable to do so.
But a lot of the girls that were in the competition, you know, they were medical students, they had master's degrees, they were intelligent women. And it's a big misconception that pageant girls are dumb. I think normally whenever I perform, I always get nervous. Everyone gets nervous. It's usually just right before it starts that you're just like, oh God, what's gonna happen? Don't fall. Don't be that girl who falls. Everyone's gonna talk about the girl who falls, and no one fell. The dress is like the opening number dress. It looks like a gigantic chandelier or a disco ball. And then you could see out in the audience where people bring they bring signs and noisemakers and glow sticks, and they just scream. It was great. So I had my own little cheering section. My friends made all sorts of ridiculous signs, like there was one claiming that I was a super ninja and had a big picture of me on it as a ninja. And they did all sorts of crazy stuff like that, and they were screaming for about 10 minutes. And then they announce all the awards, they you know, crowned Miss DC 2010.
If I could describe the competition in just a few words, I'd have to say it's a learning experience, for sure. I got to learn a lot of things about interview and, you know, presenting myself with people, and they would take us to cocktail parties and introduce us, like, the contestants for Miss DC 2010. And then we'd get to schmooze with politicians, so I got to learn how to work my way around a room and, you know, smile and wave. I got a chance to talk to Miss DC 2008, and, you know, she was telling me, you know, she's got a $250,000 education and she's debt-free. It's fantastic. And then you get to meet so many people, especially being in DC, because the connections that the competition, the organization has, just, they can take you places, and they get people, they get you an education, they can get you all sorts of internships, and it's, they can take you places. It's great. It's an experience.